Thank you. So as the day is getting shorter, also presentations are getting shorter a bit. I have 6 minutes time. This morning we had already a presentation from Maximilian, and he beautifully said that each IoT technology has its positive and negative aspects, and that's the topic I'm going to speak today about why are the different IoT technologies. Typical question: what is the best car? You don't have to be worried. I'm not selling cars today, but when I get asked what's the best IoT technology, it's very difficult to say. And then I come with the counter question. I ask the person whoever asked me the question, so what is the best car for you? And then a discussion starts. Do you want to go off-road? Then maybe Land Rover. Do you want to go to the racetrack? Then you maybe take a Porsche 911. And it's a bit the same with the IoT technologies. You need to identify which is the use case and which is the most appropriate IoT technology. But before we go into a bit deeper into the different kind of IoT technologies, is the big question is, why are companies or governmental institutions doing IoT? And we have here the beautiful circle of IoT. One topic is the economic value. Can I generate money? Am I a telecom operator? Can I resell the connectivity? What we see mostly when it's about the economic effect is companies saving money. IoT is there to save money, like we have agriculture products, projects in Ecuador doing chagrin plantations, and they manage to reduce the water consumption up to 80%, so they are saving a lot of money. The other is also connected to water, for instance, it's a social value. What can I do better for the world? How can I improve the security? How can I do something for people, for my employees, etc.? And the third one is the environmental, which is also in combination with all the rest. Here we see a nice overview. I mean, today we have already heard about LoRaWAN, IoT, 2G, 3G, up to 6G, where we see a potential use in 10 years. And there are many other technologies like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, etc., etc. Here you see a very nice graph in where some technologies are better than the other ones. So why do we have so many different technologies? And as Maximilian said, every technology has something positive, something negative. And I compare it a bit with the economical rules. If you want to improve inflation, you cannot improve in the same time unemployment. So you turn a wheel in one side and you turn the wheel on the other side. This is why we have different technologies. Some technologies are better to have a really heavy payload. Other technology has super long range or low powered. What we think from our side, that the biggest potential is still on low power wide area networks, because to be honest, most of the sensors are small. They transport very small data, GPS coordinates, temperature, humidity, metering information, whatever. And for most of the cases, these technologies are more than enough. What we are doing is the network server, where you see here in the middle. And we are the first worldwide having a network server that is providing LoRaWAN and IoT in the same time, in the same server, in the same platform. Why are we doing this? To us, it is important, and we see the future, that the future companies, they will not only use one technology, they will have different protocols using and adapting the use cases to the technologies and vice versa. What we are doing is, we are enhancing our product, we are making it possible, flexible with the hardware, with the gateways and the protocols, so that our partners and customers in the end can build a big IoT network and pick whatever they want in the network. With this, I'm done for my part, and I would like to hand over to my colleague, Uwe.
Thank you very much. So welcome to the second part of this presentation. It's all about sustainability, and in this case, it's making existing assets smart and using reverse and forward digitalization. You are thinking to yourself, like, what in the heck is reverse digitalization? Well, it is basically coming from a customer of us who was one of a huge chemical client, and was a field-to-cloud guy. I guess he was a Dutch gentleman. And he said to me, what we like to do is we like to take already approved products. We are selling any kind of sensors in any vertical you can imagine. That's the reason why you will find no product in my presentation. So I'm not only active even in the founding phase of MyoT. So I'm also representing Vika as a global senior advisor for IoT, going really deep into the application and showing all our solutions, our products would basically blow this presentation. So reverse means simply that we take existing approved devices in the assets of the customer. And since one disruption is chasing the other, you have to understand that some of the assets, they have an ROI, a return on invest time of 20 plus years. So how are you dealing? So you have here the Ferrari driving around and all your planning, for example, a refinery is worth 4 billion euros. So what are you going to do? Scrap it, start over? This is not an option. So the option is you need for sure leverage all the advantages of these technologies to really reach the efficiency. So having that said, we have three things in common. Efficiency, we are clear. We know that, of course, sustainability includes efficiency and vice versa. But another thing is risk management or disaster prevention. And I would like to take you through a journey, not through our products, but into the world of the customer. And there's a saying like, if you want to understand the pains and how your partner, your customer is thinking and feeling, you have to walk in the shoes. I would not recommend that. Talk to them quite openly. So wind turbine. In Germany or in Europe, everybody totally agrees that green energy, wind turbine is a must, and of course also solar. Question, what do you think, what is your opinion? Is this wind energy, generating it, obviously better than nuclear? Is it harmless or not? You just had a break, arms up or down? You have a 50-50 chance, it's a fair offer. Well, this is the truth and the facts. If you want to operate a wind turbine, you need to switch the energy, that means the generated energy, to somewhere. You have to distribute it. And they are called TSOs, transmission system operators. To do that, you have to have an isolation gas because the top of this wind turbine has limited space. So you have to have a gas which isolates this medium voltage switch to prevent that you have a shortage which will generate you 4,000 and more amps, which then is more or less a welding operation to the point that you have your wind turbine on fire, looking like one of these Chinese wheels, spinning wheels on New Year's. And the only way to deal with such a fire is that you have a controlled burn down. So that means you can check 1 million off of your return on invest calculation. So, but even worse, so we have the fire. We talked about the gas, and everybody talks about the footprint up to the point that we have too many cows on this planet. Here, the green energy and the wind turbine, 1 kilogram of SF6 gas equals, if we release it out of one wind turbine, 22.8 tons of CO2. 1 kilogram. So now I was asking myself, how many wind turbines do we have in Germany? Well, we have 28,000, adding up to 2.6 million tons of CO2 only in Germany. So now we have all these talks about carbonization or decarbonization and CO2 and how bad it is. This is a real problem and this is a real figure. So now the question, after my speech, so wind turbines, not for us? No, you have to manage the risk and you have to prevent disasters, and that's exactly what we do. So what is the challenge? We need to detect leakages. Again, 1 kilo, 23 tons. What we need to do is, we have to predict whether we have enough gas in there, because we don't want to have New Year's Day in June. Yeah? Third, disaster prevention, we have to set an alarm. And of course, to add on and on, our solution, of course, all of them, IIoT supported, we can also recycle the gas. We can set the indicators and say, hey, you have around about 4 more weeks where you can operate pretty cool. Then it's getting critically and iffy. And then it's time to really rechange or refill or better recycle it. Don't waste the gas. Why would you? It's also not cheap. So the solution is we have an IIoT sensor which is basically not measuring only the pressure in the vessel or in this device. It basically tells the system already on a little bit of a miniature edge computing how good the isolation status is. Tells them the humidity and tells them how long they can safely operate it in the perfect isolation condition. Would you have thought that? I don't think so. So, and this is, by the way, this is such a switch. Second one, we heard about Ogi, my friend in crime, if it comes to instrumentation. This is a refinery, this is the 4 billion or 4 billion euro operation. Of course, they also want to leverage IoT. So the nightmare is, if you want to add new points, you have to go through their instrumentation pyramid, up to the SCADA unit and up, of course, to the applications. That's very critical because those are critical infrastructure. You have to document every step you do. You cannot just simply put a cable, and if you have an I/O spot which is open, you still have to go through all the fireworks. So I call it a firewall, it's not fireworks. So I call it the golden route. Yeah, can also be a firework. So you bypass it, you take all your LP1 systems in there, and of course, ATEX or explosion-proof devices, you integrate them, you set them into a data lake, and as Ogi already explained, MQTT client, you just simply send it to the control systems. Like that. How can we do it? Very simple. The best way and the easiest and inexpensive way is that you take existing devices, you make them smart by bridging them. Pest control. We have a wonderful example of Rattus norvegius, which is the brown traveling rat, Norwegian mostly. And the buffet for them is, for example, a kind like a silo operation like we have here, in this case in Hamburg. So you have water, you have food, and you have closing hours. So nobody's there at night, so this is when the party starts. This is the guy who tries to prevent that the corn, because they make babies and so on, and they are in the corn, so you have the bacteria, and you have to waste all this corn to feed the people who need this food and this corn dramatically. So we use IoT, or we need to get this Rattus norvegius out of this silo operation. So what do? We have a pest control guy who needs to control all these traps. So over there, alone over here, we have 800. And you need to control them daily by law. You have to document it and you have to do all the things. So this guy is ideal weight, I guarantee you. He walks I don't know how many kilometers every day. So IoT is going to solve the problem, so we don't eliminate the guy, so he's still alive, but he doesn't have to walk these 18 kilometers anymore. And of course, we have a documentation. This is our pest control center, which we provide. Next one, over here, you see a conveyor band, not a problem. It's only a problem if the ball bearings are getting hot. So we measure the temperature. You have corn on this conveyor band, on the cluing bearing. Sets the corn on fire, the corn goes into the silo, in the silo you have dust, and you have a beautiful case of dust explosion. So we can set an alarm and say, hey, you better check your ball bearing, otherwise you can use your brown brick somewhere in the harbor, so and you don't have a building anymore. Other case, we're talking about sustainability in wasting goods. We control the suction of this one, 1,000 tons. If we don't control and set an alarm, this room is filled with corn. And it takes, I don't know how long, it takes the operation out of functionality, that's clear, but also to clean the space is also a lot. Last but not least, we talk about data security, and I'm done. This is an example out of the Middle East. So we heard about conclusions, how to save water and so on, but I think the real kicker on top of that is behavioral change. And what you see over here, this is a real screenshot from a handy. So this is the consumption of water, and he sees exactly his neighbor in the neighborhood. He also sees his daughter and says, he has 2 kids more, 6 more cars, and he still uses less water than you. You do something wrong. So possibly in the best way, he talks to his neighbor, said, how the heck are you doing this? And he will say, close your garden hose. The same thing you have with electricity. We talk about sustainability. also over here. So, just for you, so what is OXS? When we go into a project, we look forward to provide an outcome as a service, not even a solution. What does our customer want to accomplish? And I like to close with IIoT is the enabler for a better sustainable world. And I totally believe it. And it helps us to understand the correlations of the systems. We don't know. We don't really know, and we have a lot to learn. And AI is helping us, because maybe our brain capacity, which we can operate and control, is too small. And we can choose, depending on that, fit to purpose and interventions. And we should don't even care about what protocol we take. I mean, I'm a MIOTI guy, and I know why, okay? And that's it. If you have questions, come and see us at the MIOTI booth. Thank you very much for being here and listening to me.